What's up, lovers? How are you doing today? Today, I am making a video about 10 special secret places to kiss on a woman. Yes, I know you guys only be thinking the lips, and sometimes the lips, because some of you I heard don't kiss those lips. Or I even heard, well, when we have sex, you don't kiss me. You don't kiss your lips, these ones? To me, that's crazy, but you guys be doing a bunch of shit. I don't know. Anyways, let me not start with talking shit, but let me talk to you about some places that you might not think about just because you're like, oh no, that's nothing. No, it's special. It's special. And she's gonna go, ah, crazy, please, baby, take me now. You want her to act like that. Yeah. All right, so we're gonna jump right in. Number one, behind the knees. I know. You were like, what? Really? For real? Yes, really? For real? Behind the knees, you know, she's on her stomach. I don't know what you're doing. Hopefully you're doing something good. Go down and like go to her knees. Behind. The back of the knees. She's gonna go crazy. Nobody's kissing there. That's one. And two, it's so, let me say that word, erogenous. I think I said it right. She's not gonna be able to handle. She's gonna be like, oh, what is this? Oh, that's new. Yes, that's new. Nobody's doing it. So do it. Be the one doing that for her. Maybe what you do is you start with the feet. Hopefully she smells good. Start from the feet and then work your way up. Caress the calves and then get behind those knees. While you're back there, number two, the lower back. Oh my God. So just think about it. The lower back is pretty much so close to the pussy. It's close to the pussy. So it's gonna do the little tingly in the vagina, but it's gonna be really just the lower back. It is so fucking sensual. Please, please, you do this to me and I'm like, yo, just, can we stop? Stop kissing. Just give it to me. You want her to be like that. So it's getting hot in here, but I want to pause real quick because Underdog Fantasy is sponsoring the video today, and Underdog Fantasy is the easiest way to get some action on the NFL. It's the best place to play fantasy sports. Underdog Fantasy lets you draft a fantasy dream team in minutes. The website is super easy, so you can just jump in and start making money. So if you sign up with my promo code Melly, you'll double your first deposit up to $100 in bonus cash. So you deposit $10, you get $10. You deposit $100, we give you $100 in free cash. I don't think you can beat that. And like it wasn't enough, Underdog decided to add a mystery special pick. So when you do the pick'em games, which is the easiest way for me to make money, with that mystery pick, pretty much you win automatically on your first pick. Automatically, you don't even gotta think about it. Pick'em games are super easy. You just pick lower or higher on your favorite or least favorite player stats, and you can win up to 20 times your money in one single night. One single night. You can also pick from rivals, which put two players against each other, and also you can create a draft just for yourself, a private one, where you invite me so then I can play with you and I can kick your ass. Yes. I'm telling you, this shit is pretty fun. So I don't know what you're waiting for right now. And we can make some money. That's the biggest for me. So you should go on the website. Make sure you put my promo code Melly so you double your first deposit up to $100 and you get the mystery special pick. Yes. Go over there. Oh, you know, they have the app store too, actually. Go on the app. It's probably easier. And still put my code, Melly. Also, I made it easier for you. You can click the link in the description of this video and it will take you right over there. You don't got no excuse now. Just go. Number three that you guys don't do, the collarbones. Oof. You guys do the neck. It's cool. I'm not complaining about the neck. Fucking, I'm not complaining about the neck, but the collarbone. Nobody does that. This is sexy. This is next level. You nibble, you bite a little bit. You're like, oh no, not too much. You suck. You do some stuff, but right here, I'm telling you, it does something. Number four, her hips. My hips don't lie. I'm telling you, yeah, the hips don't lie. I'm telling you, because when you start biting on the hips, you know, it's close to the pussy, and we start thinking, oh, he's gonna go down, he's gonna go down. Oh, no, he's not. What I tell you all the time, it's all about anticipation. We are in her head thinking, he's going, please touch it, touch it, touch it, touch it. And then you don't. You don't touch right away. You make her wait. No, bitch. No, don't call her bitch. No, not yet. You gotta wait. And then you just nibble and you know, and she's moving, she's moving. She's gonna try to put the pussy in your mouth. But yes, I'm telling you, the more she's ready, the more she's anticipating you to do something and you're not doing it, the more when you actually do it, she's gonna go crazy. Trust me. Number five, I said the neck earlier, but now I'm talking about the back of the neck. The back of the neck, nobody goes there. Most girls have hair, so you don't go over there. Go over there. It's a lot of nerves. It's super sensitive. You know, when she's like laying on her stomach, just go. Ah! Number six, her hand, her fingers, palms. You guys, I know you guys are like, no, that don't do nothing. I am telling you, it does a lot. And also, not just on some sexual shit, just it's affection. It is really affectionate. Even just now, you're gonna make her think like you really fuck with her and you really like her. I am telling you. Number seven, her face, her forehead. Yeah, I know, I got a big one. My forehead needs love too. So kiss me, but like the face, like the cheeks, like everywhere on her fucking face. This is so sensual, this is so intimate, and that really convey a message of love. I know you might not love the bitch, but if you want to have her as a repeat customer, you need to do all these little extra stuff, because she's gonna feel like you love her and she's gonna come back. Number eight, her ears. Ears, go in the ear, not smacking. We don't want the smack, that shit is too loud. We don't want hella saliva either, but just blow a little bit of hot hair. You know when somebody does, and hopefully your breath is fine, because we might smell it even if you're in the ear. So just go like a little hot. I am telling you, so many nerves, and it goes straight to the pussy. Crazy, right? You're kissing the ear, but in reality, you're kissing the pussy, so do it. Number nine, her nipples. I think this one you guys know, because you like titties, but some of you be way too aggressive. You know, when we get aroused, we are not as sensitive to pain. So the more we arouse, the more pain we can take. But some of y'all just be going like, ah, right away. And I'm like, you're hurting me at this point. So make sure you work your way up. Like, you know, she got to be aroused a little bit more and more and more. And then you can go a little harder, a little harder. Nibble on them, play like radio buttons, trying to find the right station to her pussy. And lick them. Do what you gotta do, but make sure you are in tune with how she's reacting, how she's moving, how she's moaning. Is she like, yo, what are you doing? You know you're doing something wrong. You know, you gotta pay attention to her body language mostly, because she might not say nothing and just take the pain. But yeah, nipples. Nipples are super fucking sensitive. You guys know that. Also, it was a study that shows that when you stimulate the nipples, it releases an hormone called oxytocin, which is the love hormone. So it's gonna bond you with her. I don't know if you wanna be bonded. I don't know. Think about it before you do it. But yes, she will feel more connected to you. That's a study. I'm not making this shit up. And then number 10, which is my fucking favorite. I should have said that number one, but anyway, hopefully you're still here watching. Number 10, inner thighs. Again, it goes with anticipation. You go inside the thighs, you kiss, you lick, you caress, you maybe caress with your dick, not just with your hand. We're thinking you're about to go in, about to go in with the dick, with the hands, with your face. We think you're about to go in. I'm spitting. I'm saliving, I guess, just thinking about it. I'm thirsty. Yeah. Oof. It's hot in here. Okay. But that's it. The inner thighs. Make sure you act like you're going, but you're not. Several times. And then you finally go. Because at some point, she's going to be like, yo, stop playing with me. Stop fucking playing with me. Just fuck me. Please. Okay. This is enough. I think it's time for me to leave the house. Yes. All right. Well, I hope this helps. If you haven't been kissing those areas, please start doing so today, and watch how she's gonna be like, have you been cheating on me? Because those moves, those kisses, where they come from? No, you gotta do them. I'm telling you, you gotta do those. All right, everybody, you can like, share, comment. I'm clapping. I need to go. I'm crazy right now. You can like, share, comment. What else you can do? You can book a one-on-one video call with me on Patreon at www.patreon.com/Melly Monaco. Make sure you check Underdog Fantasy. I'll be on there playing. You can also follow me on Instagram, Melly Monaco, Melly Lavexo, Melly Motors, Melly Travel, The Pineapple Show. I'm sorry, it's a lot for you to go find me other places, but hopefully you'll be there. All right. I appreciate you subscribe to this channel, at least. That's the least you can do for me. Thank you. But I love you. I hope you're having a great day. I hope you're going to implement those because she's going to be like, you need to fuck me more. Yes. All right. Goodbye.